Hello, Yarnabees. How are you today? Excuse me. Well, at least you could tell by my coffee caper this morning. Today started off not so wonderful. excuse me. We'll get into all of that later. Okay. Coffee. What was it called? Rodeo something. Something rodeo. You guys saw it. okay, let's try it. Okay, apparently I did not put enough creamer in it. Oh, hold on. Continuation. Let's see. Wow, was that a dark roast? I didn't even look. I don't have my glasses on when I do that, so I don't know. But holy man, that's strong. That'll get me going. Oh, you guys. I debated whether or not to even do this vlog today. And it's not for the reason that you think. Whoops. Oh, moving stuff. of course, you guys saw my video yesterday about Kimi. I was not expecting backlash. So, excuse me, without getting into too much detail. What am I saying? I mean, you OGs know me. I call shit the way it is. And all the new Cinebees out there, if you have heard Jennifer talk about me, you know that I don't take crap from anybody. Yesterday, I was at a vulnerable point, and I let somebody, I actually let a couple of people dictate a few things to me. And you know, it's usually I don't oh, now my battery's dying, for God, for the love of God, hold on. Okay, can we get this done? Holy cow. Alright, yeah, so first off, I got a private message from another YouTuber on my personal phone line. I'm starting to really regret giving out my phone number to certain people because anyways, I got a personal message saying, turn off your monetization on that video. Well, I'm sorry, but I was in a mess yesterday and I was on autopilot, and I'm sorry if I forgot to do that. So I says, sorry, okay. And I went and did that. Then in the comments, her bestie blasted me for doing the video at all and said that me and everybody else should be mourning in private. You go ahead and you mourn in private. But number one, don't ever dictate to me how I should mourn. Don't ever dictate to me or anyone else how they should mourn. Everybody mourns differently, and your way is not always the right way for most people. Number two, if you look in the comments of that video, the majority of the people that knew Kim didn't even know what happened. They just thought she disappeared. And they were worried. And they weren't subscribed. A lot of them weren't subscribed to Angela's channel. So they thanked me for doing that, because otherwise they would never have known. Now, one of my worst fears, and I went on to my members' videos and I talked to my members about this, because I was so irate. I skipped all of my grieving levels, like all of the steps of grieving, and I went straight to anger and rage over this. And I fumed all day yesterday and went to bed angry because of this. And I try really hard not to let things like this get to me. But this pissed me off, because when my husband passed away, I had people try to tell me how to grieve, and that I shouldn't be grieving as long as I have, and that, you know, maybe I shouldn't have been grieving at all. And I thought, you know what? I've got some very choice words for you. And so it has taken everything in me. I tell you, it has shaken me. Don't do that. You know, one of my fears is, when I was in the hospital and I almost died, the one thing that I was thinking about, well, there was two things I was thinking about before I went in. One was, what the hell is George going to do with all my stuff? The second was, who's going to tell my YouTube family? Because my family doesn't know how to upload videos. I got 4,300 subscribers out there. Hello. Hi. Love you all. That wouldn't have a clue of what happened. Because my bestie, Sandy Dudoff from Leftist Right Crochet, doesn't do videos anymore. And my family probably wouldn't know how to get a hold of Angela. And some of my subscribers haven't even subscribed to Angela, which I think you should do that. Go to Angela's channel and subscribe. Her link's down below. One of my members said, well, give them the information for Jennifer's channel. That's a good idea. But if I had have died, no one would have known. And I don't think that's fair to you guys. Because I've been on here for, what, six years? I don't even know anymore. And I've got a lot of people on here that have been here from the beginning that I consider friends, that would have thought, where'd she go? What happened? You know, Angela wouldn't have known, right? Jennifer wouldn't have known. So, I don't know if it's our duty as YouTubers, but I felt that it was my duty to let everybody know that didn't know. And I'm not going to feel guilty about that. And I think that, just my personal opinion, but I don't think that Kimmy's name should just go poof into thin air. I respect her too much, and I care about her too much to have that happen. You know, she was a talent, that woman. She gave a lot to the community, like I said. And for her to just go gone isn't right. So some people might disagree with me, and at this point I don't care, because I don't think anybody should be just wiped off the map and never spoken of again. And as that whole grieving in silence, that's crap. Because as someone who knows what grieving is all about, the worst thing that you could do is grieve in silence, because that's where trouble comes, right? You need to be able to talk to people. You need to be able to talk to someone about how you feel, right? Because if you don't, ugliness creeps up. And you don't want to go down that road. Trust me. So, I'm sorry I left my monetization on. Oops. It's off now. But I am not going to apologize for grieving with my YouTube family. Okay? Okay. So, anybody that decides they want to put a nasty comment in the comments cannot bother. Because I don't play that game. I don't play this game. Alright. Actually, I challenge you guys. I'm going to put Kimmy's link down below, and I want you to go down there and I want you to play the hell out of her playlist. I want you to put her playlist on and I want you to put it in the background and just let it go. And, or you can watch it even better, because she's got some really awesome stuff. Don't be a hater. Okay. Grief is a real thing. And it should never be done alone. So, enough said. I did my rant. Let's get on to the Christmas stuff. See, I've even got my Grinch shirt on. Because I'm pissed. Don't have my Santa hat on. Whatever. But we're going to move past this now. And we're going to get on to happier stuff. Okay? Okay. Let's do that. All right. Uh-oh. Okay, found it. I was like, oh, where'd my card go? All right, yesterday's question was, which soda manufacturer is often credited with popularizing the image of the bearded, apple-cheeked Santa we know today? You guys got it right. It's Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola. That stuff rots your stomach. Just saying. Okay, Coca-Cola in 1931, the company commissioned Hayden Sudbloom, whatever, to illustrate Santa for ads. The result, one of the first red-suited, rosy-cheeked, and bewhiskered Santa. Bewhiskered? Bewhiskered. Okay. So, excuse me. Interesting. I love that Santa Claus. I do. But I love the teddy bears even more. The polar bears. Oh, I love those polar bears. When that first came out, oh, I'm aging myself. When that first came out, oh my God, I was hooked. I was hooked. Not hooked enough to drink Coca-Cola, but yeah, hooked none the same. And the same with those TELUS ads with all those animals. Man, they really knew how to do their marketing. Unbelievable. Okay, question number two. Put your glasses back on, Sandy. Here we go. Okay, I can't even hold the cards today. Let's try this one. Question. Oh. Okay. This should be interesting. In Last Holiday, I'm assuming was a movie, why did Queen Latifah's character splurge on an extravagant Christmas? I don't even think I've watched that movie. Again, in the movie Last Holidays, did I say Last Christmas? Last Holiday. Why did Queen Latifah, love her, Latifah's character splurge on an extravagant holiday? I can't be extravagant, so I can't even say the word. Okay. Put your comments down below. No Googling. No Googling. There was one person in the comments the day before yesterday that I know was a Googled answer because it was too perfect. No cheating. So, okay. That's done. Oh. Ta-da! I figured out what the problem was with this. that it wouldn't let me pre-record. It wouldn't let me record my screen. They're smart. So if you get this calendar, you hit, there's a barcode. Wait, right here. Right here, a QR code. You hit that. You do all the prompts, and then every day, I think you scan the picture, and it shows you a story. So that was really cute. What day are we on? Day four? Is it day four already? Oh God, you guys, I can't even think. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, yeah, I guess we're on day four. Where's day four? Day five? No, we don't want that. Ah, there it is, up here. Oh, it's a long one. Ooh, let's see what that is. Oh, ooh. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Okay. Ooh. I have no idea. Is it a candy or is it chocolate? It's gotta be chocolate. Oh yeah. It's a chocolate ball. That sounded really bad. Yeah. And I'm noticing with these, there's squishy stuff inside. Like caramel, chocolate, whatever. So I'll have that a little bit later. Okay. So I'll just say right now. My grandkids got wild hair, and he just got a haircut. So, just saying, when you watch this next video, or this next opening of his advent calendar, he's got, like, rooster hair and a whole bit. He has a, not a mullet. Is it a mullet? No, it's not a mullet. It's a, oh, yeah, it's, his hair's wild, okay? So, put that in here.
Okay, you gotta open this one. Open that one. Yeah. Okay. Open that one. What you got? Oh, we got another circle one. Let me help you. There you go. Yeah, you eat that one. Nom, 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 nom. Just shove the whole thing in there. Is it good? Okay. Happy day three. Hmm? Happy day three.
Hmm? All right. Anyway. that makes my day. Like, just getting videos of my grandson just makes my day. I love it. I mean, look at this picture I've got of him. I have this on my screen, my screenshot. Whoops. My screenshot. Because it's a picture of my daughter and, whoops, and my grandson. And look at this face. Can you see that? Look at that look. Is that not adorable? His facial expressions just crack me up. I don't know where that kid got. No, I do know. She is hilarious. And so is her father. I mean, yeah, okay, he's my ex. But he was funny. And he didn't even realize he was funny. Axel, I think, knows he's funny. Because he laughs about it first. I can't wait till he's grown up. Because I don't want him to grow up too fast. But he's already grown up so much. And he's turning into a little man, you know, I just watching him develop into a person is amazing in itself. So, yeah. Okay, the sweater. I totally understand that the squares on this, on the Christmas collab sweater, aren't some people's thing, or they are finding it a little complicated. Trust me, once you get into understanding the concept, it's all good. And then somebody had commented saying that the actual stitches of the sweater is complicated. The sweater is not really beginner friendly, but if you keep watching it and keep trying, you'll understand and you'll get it. You'll get it, right? Cool, it's such a comfort box.
Huh?
What? Comfort zone. Comfort zone. Holy cow. In the next video, you're going to see that I had to finagle it a little bit. But here's what it looks like so far. Okay. Holy cow, that looks big. Now that I'm looking at it. Oh, this might be a big sweater. You know what? I actually haven't put it up to me. So this is going to be... Yeah, this might be a... 3-4x sweater. Oh my god. I didn't even... I don't know. I'll have to figure it out when I get there. But that's okay. Yeah. Alright, so the next part is doing the two sides. And that comes out... tomorrow? I think it's tomorrow. Oop, might be tomorrow or it might be the day after. I can't remember what I did. I can't remember crap today. Like, my brain's just not working. So you do that, and then we're going to do the side of the sleeve panels, and then we put it all together, and then we do the collar and the cuffs. Okay, I can't think anymore. So I'm gonna go. I think I've rambled enough. Rambled and ranted. So anyway. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna go. I will talk to you guys later. I love you all. Thank you so much for your support and coming along with this. I'm sorry that today's was such a downer, but you know, yeah. Yeah. Okay. I love you all. I'll talk to you tomorrow.